How do folks, how you doing? Just a quick one. Distractions are rife again, aren't they? And all the dumb fools are falling for them again. As usual, every twist and turn must be taken with the elites. It's absolutely bizarre. The internet is absolutely full of Russell Brand. Did anybody not know that he was one of theirs? Does anybody not know that they use theirs to get your attention when your attention needs to be swayed away from the real shit? Fucking painful. It is so painful watching it every fucking time. And I say it all the time, every twist and turn. And at every single twist and turn, I seem to be saying every twist and turn. But the people still fall for it. And if they don't fall for it one way by going, oh, look what, Russell Brand's now a paedophile. Brand's a rapist. They don't fall for it that way. They fall for it by going on the internet and going, bah, 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 and showing this, that, and the other on him. Give it no energy. And I'm not oblivious to the fact I'm giving it energy here. But I'm pointing out the fucking idiots again falling for every twist and turn. The Russell Brand factor is neither here nor there. It's just one of the twists and turns. So it doesn't matter who it is. So that's one of the forms of distraction that's going on at the minute. An absolutely innocuous form of distraction that means nothing to anybody. If you ignored it, your life wouldn't change in any way, shape or form. That's just the absolute take your mind away from the bullshit. Or the reality, should I say. That is the bullshit. But then on the other, you've got this XL bully side thing. Where we know damn well they're coming for our dogs. We know they're coming for our dogs. All breeds. But they're starting with the XL bullies. So they'll get everybody focusing just on XL bullies. So it's tiptoe again, as usual. They're going to do what they're going to do with the XL bullies. And then they'll turn on another breed and then another breed. Then they'll license them. You'll have to have a license to have your dogs. Otherwise, we're going to come and take them off you and destroy them. And people will get their licenses like good little slaves. Because they have to. Otherwise, this, that or the fucking other. I won't be licensing my fuckers. Not a chance, and they won't be taking them off me either. Not a chance. But if those that want to be distracted and scared by it, get scared by it, so be it. It is gutting, and we can't ignore that one, in all honesty. I haven't got the actual answer to how they do that, because it's criminal genius, isn't it, always? They'll vilify the one breed. Everybody's up in arms, everybody sticks up for them. But unfortunately, as well as that, you have the other side of that where there are going to be some dangerous XL bullies. Just in the same way, there's some dangerous Rottweilers, some dangerous German Shepherds, some dangerous fucking Jack Russells, some dangerous Chihuahuas. There are always going to be some dangerous ones. But what you get is people on the internet blanket defending an entire breed of dog, making out that every single one of them are soft as shit and good with kids. That's not the case. So if you go to the extremes, you're also falling in the hands, because nobody's going to believe that. Don't forget, they're working on the court of public opinion. So they get the public in fear of this specific type of dog, and everybody's going, oh no, don't worry about it, they're absolutely fine, absolutely fine. Well, that ain't the case, is it? Because most of them, absolutely. Any dog from a good family, no matter what breed it is going to be absolutely fine. But there are some cunts out there that breed bad dogs and bring up bad dogs. You can't just pretend that all are okay. You have to join in reality. And I've seen some people saying it's the owners. Again, I don't know. I don't know what's the way. I really do feel for those with XL bullies. I really do. Because a dog is a dog, and a dog is love. At the end of the day, it's another animal. You'll hug them. They'll give you loads of love. They're going to give you kisses, and if you're part of your family, they're part of your family. Don't matter what breed it is. But let's not forget, this is a tiptoe. Always a tiptoe. This is just step one of coming for the dogs. Just step one. They're using this breed as step one. They're using probably a created or faked scenario for this one. So just wait for the next twist and turn, because if we focus on just this breed, we'll miss the next breed, and we'll miss the next breed, and we'll be focusing on each breed each time, and the ones that are standing up will be the ones that own it. So that's your segregation there. There's not very many people. You've got a minority standing up saying, save our dogs, and you've got the rest of the fucking dimwits saying, no, they're dangerous, they need regulation, they need taking out, they need licensing, or this, that, and the other. Not the way forward. Not the way forward. Everybody needs to come together. Always everybody needs to come together. That's the one thing that can't ever happen, because them fuckers are working against that all the time, and the people are too fucking stupid and fall for every twist and turn, as I've said many, many times. So if you just want to defend XL bullies, and I'd love to. I would love to stand here saying XL bullies are this, that and the other. But the reality is, like any dog, a dog is only as good as it's been brought up. So you can't say XL bullies are this, that or the other. Because what you're doing is falling into exact trap that they want you to fall into. Nobody's going to believe that an entire blanket breed of a very potentially dangerous dog is soft as shit. Nobody's going to believe that. So start working on the shit that they will believe, as opposed to being unrealistic about it. Because if you're unrealistic, you're not doing the cause any good. Like I say, I would absolutely love to be shouting for XL bullies. I love all dogs. They're all fantastic and they all love me. I've never met a dog yet that don't like me. Reality is, you just can't do it that way though. They're too clever. The people that are working against you have got that shit covered. And like I say, they're working with the court of public opinion. They've already worked on them. They've shown video footage of a man getting killed by one. You can't now turn around and say, they're soft. Because the court of public opinion's already had the evidence. They're not. They've already had the evidence that they're the most dangerous dogs in the world and they need banning. Evidence, you need to put some facts into it. You need to mitigate the reality of the situation as opposed to just counter it and totally deny it. It's like saying, the court of public opinion, they're already on their side. Always do that bit first before you start countering it in the way that you've been taught to counter it. And that is one of the problems of how we react whenever we do anything. As a whole, that's what needs to stop. Problem, reaction, solution. We all know that. Stop reacting the way they expect you to react. That way they can't implement their solution. Dig your heels in and go, oh, they're gonna do this. What do you expect us to do? I haven't got all the answers. A criminal genius, remember? I'm no fucking genius, I'm just a fella. It takes a group of minds coming together to come up with solutions. But unfortunately, I don't see that. I do see some groups coming together. I don't see them creating solutions for the world. I see them creating solutions for themselves. They're perfectly entitled to do that. Let them do that. But the reality is, if this is to be stopped, it is all or nothing. It's everybody or nobody. It doesn't work with small groups doing this, that and the other. It doesn't work with everybody on different pages. And it certainly don't work by reacting the exact same way they want you to react. Like I say, all the bullshit that's on the news needs ignoring. Needs absolutely dismissing. Not even honouring. And as I say, I do understand that I'm here speaking about it. But the reality is, I'm just trying to put people's fucking heads straight, as always. Trying to make people think straight. I haven't got all the answers. And you know what? Nobody else has. So stop looking for somebody else to give you the answers. Start thinking for yourselves. An absolute population of free thinkers would solve all the world's problems. But there aren't free thinkers. There's just small little isolated pockets. And very actual few out of the ones that call themselves free thinkers are actually free thinkers. Most of them are thinking within their own little box, unable to change their opinions when presented with new information on their own path, refusing to look at anything else. I don't say they should look at anything else. Everybody's own personal decision on what they do and how they do it. But you can't fucking moan at the internet if you're doing fuck all. You can't. You can't be one of them that are just sitting there expecting you to solve everything while they carry on their life just as normal, sitting in the ass, not preparing for what is coming in any way, shape or form. Either believing Trump, the White Hats, or fucking you are going to solve something. They're the idiots. And they're the ones falling for this shit every time. Jumping up and down to get the next fucking big thing into all of the news everywhere, internet and fucking mainstream, some of this. But people are just screaming and shouting it. Why? So you'll fix it. Or somebody else will fix it. Because they're just screaming and shouting it. They think they're drawing attention to it. If you talk to them, they genuinely believe that they're bringing attention to something that everybody has already had it brought to their attention with. Literally everybody. It's all over the internet. The brand thing, presumably all over the news. I don't watch the news, so I can't say. But everybody already knows. So what are you actually doing when you're sharing this shit? You think you're telling somebody? They already know. They've heard it. They've seen it. But you're going to share it anyway. And your opinion on it. It's disgusting. That's exactly what they want. That is exactly what they're after. And that is exactly what most of the fools are going to do. Problem, reaction, solution. I'll leave that there, folks. But whacking up. Wakey, wakey. It's happening. It's happening now. It's happening to you. And you all are very, very aware of it. Yet you're still going to keep falling for it. Cha-ching-ching. They've got you in the bank already. Ta-da.